What's up internet, I'm Manish from rebellionrider.com and I'm back with the tutorial which you have been demanding since the launch of Windows 10 preview. While some of you have reported some problems in the installation, others have successfully done it. For those who are still wondering, here is the tutorial on how to install Oracle Database 11G on Windows 10 Professional 64-bit. For those who have 32-bit version of Windows 10 or any version other than Windows 10 Professional, don't worry. You can still follow this tutorial as steps for installing Oracle Database 11G are the same. Having said that, let's come straight to the tutorial and start installation. In order to install the Oracle 11G, we have to download the software, which you can do by visiting the Oracle website. Go to oracle.com and click the download from the menu and choose Oracle Database. After that, you will be on this download page, accept the license agreement and scroll down a bit. Come to this Oracle Database 11G Release 2 section. Here you have different versions of Oracle 11G. Choose accordingly and download both the files, File 1 and File 2. I will download files from Microsoft Windows X64 option as I am installing 11G on Windows 10 64-bit. Those who have Windows 10 32-bit, please download files from Microsoft Windows 32-bit option. Rest of the process of installation is same for Windows 10 64-bit and 32-bit. It doesn't matter if you have Windows 10 Professional or Home or any other version. I have already downloaded the files to save the time. And here are those. Next, you have to extract these files as they are compressed. Let's do that and extract file from first folder. Rename this folder from database to database 1. Let's do the same for second folder. Let's rename this folder from database to database 2. Next, go to folder database 2, then go to this folder stage, and then go to this directory components, and copy all the directories from this components folder. Press Ctrl A to select all, and then copy. Now we have to come to our folder database 1. And here is our folder database 1. Inside this, you have folder stage. Go to it and then go inside the folder components. And now here paste all those files which we copied earlier. That's it. Now you are all set to start the setup and install the Oracle Database 11G on your Windows 10. So let's come to our folder database 1 where we have our setup.exe file. Here it is. Right click the setup.exe file and choose Run as Administrator. Accept the warning. This will start your Oracle Universal Installer. Avoid this warning, just hit Yes and move ahead. On the first screen, you need to provide your email address if you want to receive all the notifications and news alert from Oracle. If you do not want it, then simply leave these fields empty and move next. Accept this warning, it's just reminding you that you didn't provide the email ID. Hit Yes and move ahead. On the next screen, you will be presented with three different installation options. You can choose any of them according to your need. In my case, I want to install Oracle Server software and want to create a database also. Thus, I will choose the first option. If you choose the second option, then only Oracle Server will be installed and no database will be created. You can create a database after the installation of Oracle Server using DBCA. If you want to do that, then I have a video tutorial on how to create database using DBCA just for you. Link is in the description. You can go with the third option if you want to perform the upgrade of the database and software. But I will choose the first option and will hit the next and move ahead. On this step, you have to choose between server class and desktop class. If you are installing this Oracle Database 11G on your laptop or desktop, then go with the first option, which is desktop class. If you are installing this Oracle 11G on a server, which is capable enough to handle the load of all the server components and processes, then choose the second option, which is server class. In my case, I am installing Oracle Database 11G on Windows 10 Professional, which is installed on my laptop. Thus, I will choose the first option and hit the next. Here in this step, you can configure the basic settings of your database. For example, using first three text fields, you can set the Oracle base location, software location, which will be your Oracle home, and database file location, which will be the location where Oracle server will store all your important files such as data files, control files, and redo logs. Be careful while setting them. I am good with the default location, thus won't change them. Using database edition drop-down list, you can choose which database version you want to install. In my case, it's the Enterprise Edition. Next is character set. Let it be set on default. I'm good with this. If you want, you can change it. Okay, now next is global database name, which will be the name of your database, also serve as your database SID. You will need this while making connection with your database using tools such as SQL Developer. By default, it is set as ORCL. If you want, you can change it and give whatever name you want, but make sure to remember it. I suggest you to write it down somewhere as your database SID. In the next two fields, you have to give the password. This will be the password of your administrative user such as sys or system. Okay, be careful here. Write it down somewhere or remember it. This will be the password for your sys user or system user. Let's fill it up and move ahead. Don't worry about this warning. This is just saying that the password which you just entered is not as per the Oracle password standard. You can read this warning. Click yes and move ahead. OUI will check for the prerequisites such as hardware compatibility. If everything goes well, then we will be good to install it. If there is any error, then OUI will show you here. Fortunately, there is no error. Now, hit finish. Doing so will start the installation. This installation might take some time depending on your hardware. Don't go anywhere. There is one more important step left in the installation. I don't want to waste your time, thus I will fast forward it. Here we are, the last step, where we will unlock the users which we want, such as HR, Scott, or anything else. Click this password management button. Now, here in this password management window, we have all the users which are by default locked. You can unlock any of them. For example, I want to unlock HR user, thus I will find that user in this list. And here it is. Now I will uncheck this box which is in front of the name of the user and will write password and confirm it in the respective fields. Now I will hit OK. Again the same warning saying that password are not up to the Oracle password standard. Avoid and hit yes. And move ahead. Again click OK. And installation is done. Here is the link for your Enterprise Manager. Save it somewhere. But if you forgot, then don't worry. You can use your start menu entry for the Oracle software to launch your Oracle Enterprise Manager. Let me quickly show you. But before that, click this close button and finish the installation. Okay. Now, go to your start menu and search for Oracle folder. And inside the Oracle folder, search Oracle Control ORCL. Here, ORCL is my SID. In your case, it can be different. Click it. This will take you to the login screen of your Oracle Enterprise Manager. If you got this error, just don't worry. Click Advanced and then proceed to localhost. That's all you have to do. Here is the login screen of your Enterprise Manager. That's all about how to install Oracle Database 11g on Windows 10 Professional 64-bit. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, then give it a thumbs up and also share with others and help them in learning. You can also follow me on my social network for regular updates. All the links are in the show notes. And don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you soon with another tutorial. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.